The Great Commission isn't our idea. Salvation isn't our idea. It's God's idea. It's one thing for us to say we have faith in God. For me, the bigger thing is God has faith in us. He actually thinks we can finish the Great Commission. He thinks we can do it.
When CBN Asia launched in the Philippines, they did it big through a national blitz called the Answer Campaign. CBN Asia dominated the air on every major network. Gordon Robertson was there.
For Friday night, Saturday night, and Sunday night, for a solid weekend. Throughout the Philippines, the only show you could watch was a CBN show for a three-hour block. From that effort, we had 13 million salvations. The number was staggering to us that you could have that kind of impact in a culture with a weekend's worth of broadcasts.
Later that year, Gordon left his law practice and moved to the Philippines to answer God's call on his life.
He showed me in a dream. He showed me that I needed to train missionaries. I wanted to have that dream fulfilled of Filipinos going out into the world to preach the gospel.
Working with local churches, the Asian Center for Missions launched. Within 3 years, 9 training centers were operational, and the reports poured in.
Danny could hardly have imagined he would one day be in the middle of sub-Sahara Africa, sharing his faith with the unreached tribal peoples of Burkina Faso.
Right now, Asian Center for Missions has 768 missionaries working internationally in cross-cultural situations. It's trained over 1,600. I want that number to increase tenfold.
The advent of CBN Asia brought another major shift. Instead of watching overdubbed CBN programs as they had since 1976, they could now create their own programming.
When we changed it around and made it so Filipinos were producing it, they were coming up with the ideas, it was all done in Tagalog and all produced in Manila, then suddenly it was theirs. It wasn't some foreign program. And it was about what Jesus was doing in their country today, not some faraway place or faraway time. And the ministry results from that simple change were exponential. Our ratings went through the roof. What was a good rating now became a great rating. And we became number one in a time slot, which was the first time in the history of our broadcasting in the Philippines. So it became the model for everything we do around the world.
Also in 1996, a prophetic word combined with a friend's insight landed Gordon in a host chair.
We do our first shows. To my right is Connie Reyes, who's won the Best Actress Award in the Philippines 5 years running. Right next to her is Mari Kaimo, who is the number one newscaster on the number one station in the Philippines. And here I am, and I'm going, what's wrong with this picture? It should be the two of them. And then during the show, I'm the one that's supposed to lead the prayer for salvation. To my absolute amazement, the phones rang off the hook. It was like you could see a wave come through. We had hundreds of salvations from that one prayer. And that finally convinced me, okay, God must be in it because it's not me. This has to be God. The Brown and Fraser survey results for the Philippines for last year for what CBN Asia is doing eclipsed that number, with 10 million people praying with a host of a CBN Asia program to receive Jesus into their hearts. The numbers are staggering. What is happening and how God has given the increase. It is marvelous what he's done.
Ever since D.D. Robertson, a registered nurse, served with a medical missions team in the Philippines in 1995, she prayed that more could be done. A year later, Operation Blessing Philippines became a reality. And for the last two decades, local doctors, nurses, and volunteers have provided outreaches to the destitute, medical missions, feeding programs, health care, and disaster relief to heal and transform lives across the Philippines.
We now do 20 medical missions a month in the Philippines. You know, we thought 10 in a two-week period was huge. It's now 20 a month. It's gotten recognition as NGO of the Year. The work it does in Mindanao is absolutely phenomenal, and it's known for going to the places where people have absolutely no access to medical care.
For a decade prior to the launch of CBN Asia, the original Superbook series aired in the Philippines every Saturday morning. And 300,000 children joined Superbook Kids Club. Today's Superbook reaches even more homes and hearts than ever imagined.
Now 3.5 million Filipino children every single Saturday morning are seeing Superbook. For the first time in the history of the world, a generation of children can grow up knowing the stories of the Bible. That is transformational. That changes a culture. Every country needs their own CBN. Every country needs Christians mobilized, energized to take the gospel through television. And I'm going to add internet to that. So when we get that witness out there, when we get the testimony of what Jesus is doing today, out there into all the world, into every language, every tongue, and we take it seriously that we have to do this, then all of heaven rejoices and says, yes, when you're part of God's plan, success is unavoidable.